of how to draw basically. So here whatever we do in the software, it is already the solution will be available with us. So to do that, first we'll go to the AutoCAD screen. So click on switch off the grid mode and switch on the ortho mode. Then go to limits, type limits. So specify lower left corner 0 and upper right corner 297, 210, which is the sheet size of A4. Then go to zoom and say all. Then go to line. So here select the lower left corner of your sheet and click on the first button of the mouse and drag the mouse on the horizontal direction to some distance, and again click on the first button of the mouse and you drag the cursor in the upper direction. Again you click on the first button of the mouse, then press enter key. Go to offset, take the distance as 297 and select this vertical line and offset to the left side, and again go to offset, take the distance as 210 and select the horizontal line and offset to the top side, then enter. Then go to zoom, extends E, then zoom 0.5x. Then go to fillet between this vertical line and this horizontal line, fillet this vertical line and this horizontal line, and between this fillet between this horizontal line and this vertical line. Now we'll go for zoom window and take the D text here, and here DT, select this and you click on the first button of the mouse, specify start point, so take 4 and take the rotation angle as 0 and type the 78 problem. Then go to the elevation and in bracket you write it as front view of a line capital AB 90 mm long, comma, is inclined at 30 degree to HP and measures 70 mm, comma, the end capital A is 20 mm above HP and is in VP. Draw the projections of the line and find the inclination with VP. Once you do that, then go to zoom previous, then go to layer, click on new, click on XY and enter. Again click on new and type this as views, then go to new, click on now you type the name of the layer as true length, and click on new, type the name of the layer as locus and say okay. Now we need to change the line weights of individual layer. To do that, so go to layer 0, click on line weight, in default make it as 0.05 and say okay, and click on XY layer line weight default, which is make it as 0.13 and say okay. Click on views layer line weight default and click on 0.5 and say okay. Then go to true length layer of line weight and then make it as 0.25 and say okay. And in locus you click on default and make this as 0.05 and say okay. And this line type of locus continuous, you click on this, go to load, click on dash dot and say okay, and click on dash dot and make that dash dot as the line type of that particular layer of locus. Now once we do that, and finally you just say close and go to zoom extents and then draw the horizontal line. Now we're going to draw by using AutoCAD software. Now first we're going to draw a line of any distance and go to offset and take the distance as 20, and then you just click on this and take it to the top side, and then go to line, take nearest point on this and draw a perpendicular to this, then go to line, nearest point on this and draw a perpendicular line to this, and go to fillet between these two. Then we have the true length of the line, int intersection at the rate 90 mm less than 30. This is the true length of the line. And then draw a horizontal line. Then we have the locus line. So now we will go for circle, take intersection point of this and take the radius, the front view, which is 70 mm. So take the radius as 70 and draw the circle. Go to break. So here now you will just break this line till here and then go to trim, then go to line, draw a line from intersection point of this to intersection point of this, then go to trim, trim between these two and here, and go to fillet between these two. Once you do that, now we go for line, draw a line from the front view to the top view, then go to line, take intersection point of this to perpendicular to this, then go to extend this line, this horizontal line till here. So this is the boundary edge and this will going to be the object to extend. So then come down to zoom window, go to circle, take intersection point of this to intersection point of this line, then go to trim. So from here you take between these two and trim it here, then trim it here, then go to line, draw a line from here to intersection point of this, and then go to line, take intersection point of this and draw a horizontal line, and similarly extend the same line till here. So this is the boundary edge, so this is going to be the extension. Go to trim, trim this till here. Now we need to write the true length down in the top view once you have been rotated. So go to line, take intersection point of this, draw perpendicular to this, and again you take intersection point of this. Then go to, now this is how you will be able to solve this problem. Now we'll go for removing the extra lines. Break, and from here you break this, and from here you break this, and from here you break this, from here you break this, and from here you break this. Go to erase, then go to move, select this and move it here, and similarly you just click on this, go to change CH, go to layer, make this layer as XY and escape. Similarly you take between these two, go to layer, you make this as the views lines and click on this line weight, switch on, then go to these two and you make this layer as true length and say escape. Similarly you click on this and you click on this and make that layer as locus layer, and this will going to be the line type, which will going to be 10. So escape. Now we need to write the text, so go to dtext. So you click on X, you type Y, you type VP and you type HP, then we have capital letter A, and here also capital letter A, and here it is capital B, and here it is locus of B, and here it is locus of B, and here it is capital B, and remove the caps lock. Now you type small a dash, this is b dash, and this is b, and this is b1, and this is b1 dash, and this is b2 dash, and this is b2. Now just press enter. Now go to move, switch off this. So you type X, you type VP, you type HP, this is small letter A, this is capital letter A, this is B, this is B2, this is locus of B, this is capital letter B, and this is B1, this is B2 dash, and this is A dash, and this is A, and this is B dash, this is B, this is B1 dash, this is locus of B, this is B, capital B, So this is how you will be able to get this. Now we need to write the dimensions. To do that, first we are going to set the dimensioning variables. Click on modify, go to lines, go to offset from origin, you make it as 3. Then symbols and arrows, take the arrow size as 4. Then go to text, take the text height as 4. Align with the dimension line, center will become above, and offset from origin is 3. And then go to primary units, you make this linear dimension as 0, precision, angular dimension up to second decimal point, and say OK and say close. Now we will go for dim vertical, take intersection part of these two. So you're going to get this as 20. Then dim align, select between these two, so it will going to be 70. And dim align between these two, so you're going to get it as 90. Then dim angular, dim angle, select between these two, so which is 30 degrees. Then go to dim angular. So we need to find out what is the angle between these two. So this angle is 38.94. Then go to text, give space, enter, and you place it wherever you want. Now once we do that, then you come out, take leader, take nearest on this, and draw tangentially to this. Go to annotation, options, none. Similarly, leader, take nearest on this, and then leader, annotation, options, none. So you go to leader, nearest on this. So here, you put the ortho mode on, option, none. Then go to leader, nearest, this, and go to annotation, option, none. Then go to explode, explode these two, this line, okay, and this line. Then go to erase, erase this line, then go to this. Then DDIM, go to modify, primary units, you make the precision as 0, say OK, and say close. Then go to DDD, select this, and take this here. Then go to mText, mt, select all. And now here, select the font name as symbol. So type this, and type it as 5, type small letter F. So you're going to get this. Now we need to write the answer. To do that, so go to dtext. So click on type the answers. Then go to line, select this line, and draw a horizontal line. And here you take offset 7 mm. So here, then you come down to this. Then go to dtext. You type 38.94 %d. And you enter it. Then go to line, nearest point on this, and draw a perpendicular to this. Then go to fillet between these two. Similarly, then go to copy, switch off the ortho mode, click on this copy, and take this here. Then go to our line, take end point of this to end point of this. Then go to line, take endpoint of this and drag it to vertically, then go to between these two. So this is how you will be able to write the answer. Now we need to save this. So go to save, click on appropriate directory, E, AutoCAD, go to line drawings. So here it is P78 and say save. Then finally, you exit the